Mr. Secretary.
Mr. Bird.
Sir.
Did you hear the news about good old General Mercer?
No.
You know Claremont Street?
Yeah.
They renamed it after him. The Mercer legacy is secure.
Sure.
And all he had to do was die.
Yeah, that's a lot less work.
We ought to give it a try. Now, how you gonna get your debt plan through?
I guess I'm gonna finally have to listen to you.
Really?
Talk less. Smile more. Do whatever it takes to get my plan on the Congress floor.
Now, Madison and Jefferson are merciless.
Well, hate the sin, love the sinner.
Hamilton.
I'm sorry, Burr, I gotta go.
But
decisions are happening over dinner.
Two Virginians and an immigrant walk into a room.
Diametrically opposed foes.
They emerge with a compromise, having opened doors that were
previously closed, bros.
The immigrant emerges with unprecedented financial power, a system he can shape however he wants. The Virginians emerge with the nation's capital. And here's the pièce de résistance. No one else was in the room where it happened, the room where it happened, the room where it happened. No one else was in the room where it happened, the room where it happened, the room where it happened. No one really knows how the game is played, the art of the trade, how the sausage gets made. We just assume that it happens. But no one else is in the room where it happens.
Thomas Crane.
Alexander was on Washington's doorstep one day in distress and disarray.
Thomas Crane.
Alexander said,
I've nowhere else to turn.
And basically begged me to join the fray.
Thomas Crane.
I approached Madison and said, I know you hate him, but let's hear what he has to say.
Thomas Crane.
Well, I arranged the meeting. I arranged the menu, the venue, the seating.
But no one else was in the room where it happened. The room where it happened. The room where it happened. No one else was in the room. Settled by committee.
Meanwhile,
Congress is fighting over where to put the capital. It isn't pretty. Then Jefferson approaches with the dinner and invite, and Madison responds with Virginian insight.
Maybe we can solve one problem with another and win a victory for the Southerners. In other words, a quid pro quo.
I suppose.
Wouldn't you like to work a little closer to home?
Actually, I would.
Well, I propose the Potomac.
And you'll provide him his votes.
Well, we'll see how it goes.
Let's go.
No.
What else was in the room where it happened?
Forgive me, I wanna build something that's gonna outlive me.
What do you